Hi, I'm Sviatoslav, and today I will show you how to do such original wall clock from oak and epoxy resin. I will use an oak block for this project. I fix it on a platform with a rope and make several cuts on a bandsaw. The wood is fresh, so humidity is high. I dry the slabs with the help of a radiator for a week. After this process, the slabs are dried and have decorative cracks. I fix the slab with the help of hot glue. For the next step, I will use the 6-pin rotor cutter. I have already used this cutter in my previous video, slab table, which you can watch by clicking the link above. First, I level one surface of the slab. Then the second. There will be two gears made of two slabs in the clock face. I prepare plywood templates for their manufacture. I fasten the gear template to the slab and cut off the excess on the bandsaw. Then I give the final shape with the help of a flush trim bit. Similarly with a larger gear. I make internal saws using top bearing rotor bit. Cracks must be cleaned from the detached fibers. I make a mold for pouring epoxy resin from a PVC sheet. I found a dish of a suitable diameter. I fasten the side with a stapler and attach it to the base with hot glue. In order for the epoxy resin not to flow out of the mold, it is necessary to walk around the joint with a sealant. Next, I mix the components of the epoxy resin in the right proportion and add the white dye. Then fill the mold. after 7 days the resin completely solidified. I level the surface in the already known way. I'm starting to cut out the elements on the clock face. For this, a CNC machine would be perfectly useful. Since I have not got such, I decided to order a plywood template for plunge rotor. I have prepared a drawing for making a template in SketchUp software and ordered it. First, I attach an auxiliary drawing to the clock face and drill the center. Then I put a template on the dowel, insert it in the hole and cut out all the elements of the clock face, rotating the template along the lines in the auxiliary drawing. Then I align the outer edge of the workpiece with the plunge rotor. I complete the process of forming the edge with the help of a bottom bearing rotor bit. I fill the elements of the clock face with epoxy resin with added black dye. Again, the alignment process. On the back side, it is necessary to cut out the cavity for installing the clock mechanism. For this, I use a plywood template and a rotor guide brush. Next is the sanding process. I cover the clock face with oil and remove the excess with a lint-free napkin after a few minutes. I start assembling the watch after the oil have dried. The mechanism is attached with a nut. I put on the hour and minute hands. That's all. The original clock gears made of oak and epoxy resin are ready. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, put your thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, leave comments and ask questions.